Welcome to another edition of Yes, We're Here. I'm Meredith Marakovitz alongside Yankees hitting coach Marcus Timms. Marcus, how have you and your family been getting by during this crazy time?
We've been doing okay. The weather's been nice here in Tampa, and we've been trying to keep the kids busy. They've been having virtual schooling, and then we try to get them in the pool and get them out in the yard, play some ball, and just do some family activities. But it's been good. It's been good for us so far.
I've noticed there have been some TikTok videos, too. Are you an expert yet?
No, not even close. The kids, they try to trick me on there, but I try to stay out of there.
Have you been helping out with the virtual schooling?
A little bit, and then they get mad at me. They think my schooling days are over. They'd rather let their mom do it.
Well, we'll leave that to her. I know you've been busy, even though baseball technically isn't going right now. You've been going to the facility for quite some time. Are there a lot of guys working out right now? What's the protocol in going to the facility?
Just trying to make sure we stay safe, listen to the health officials. But guys are trying to get as much work in as possible. So it's been breaking up the monotony, just being at home all the time. So I get a chance to go in 3 days a week. We try to keep our distance outside when we're with the guys. But it's been good so far with the guys.
You mentioned the safety aspect. That's first and foremost, that everybody is protecting themselves. But I imagine for somebody that's been involved with baseball their entire life, it has to be a little different to take some of those safety precautions just based on what you were used to doing on a daily basis.
Whatever it takes for us to keep ourselves healthy and safe, we're all for it so we can get to play a little baseball.
Well, everyone's hopeful that baseball will be back and hopefully back soon. What do you have the guys go through right now, not really knowing when a second spring training could be starting or when the actual season could be starting?
The guys aren't here. They send me a video of them swinging, just doing the same routine they're doing during the season, just making sure they're staying a little bit up the beat. And the guys here, we get out on the field, take some BP, get off the machine. The guys are trying to do as much as possible to just make sure they're ready to go if we get ready to go again.
For those guys that aren't down in Tampa, and there are a good number that aren't down here, you talked a little bit about looking at their swing, trying to stay connected in that regard, but has that been difficult, that correspondence of trying to just make sure you're on top of everything?
Yeah, I try to give them their space too, because I know they have families and everybody's going through different things, so I try to give them their space, and we have a really good group of guys, so I know when to connect with them and when not to, so I get a FaceTime call here and there, but myself and my assistant, PJ, we try to stay in contact with all of us.
Now, as far as the guys that are at Steinbrenner Field or at the facility coming in and working, what can you tell us about some of those guys, Giancarlo Stanton in particular, who Aaron Boone said a week and a half ago should be ready when baseball gets going again? How's he been looking in the cage?
He's been looking good. I mean, I think his swing is where it needs to be, and we've been hitting off the machine and hitting BP on the field. He's a pro. He comes in and get his work in and trying to make sure he's healthy and ready to go. And I think his teammates are excited about that.
What's the general vibe been like at the facility?
It's different. It's weird, not having all the guys here. Boone's back home with his family, just not having everybody here. But we just try to keep play music, just try to keep it loose as possible and try to stay positive. And guys are really hoping that we can get a chance to get back on the field.
Now, I know Aaron Judge is still recovering from that fracture in his rib. Has it been difficult to keep him out of the cage, Marcus? Because he's a guy that I'm sure is dying to get in there and start taking some hacks.
Yeah, it's been tough. He walks by the cage. He comes in to help the guys pick up balls. And he really wants to get going. But we just try to stay safe. And when the doctors let him turn him loose, he'll be ready to go. But he's chomping at the bit to get out there and start working hard on his swing.
From a hitting perspective, what are going to be some of the biggest challenges in starting a spring training, stopping for a while, and then getting things ramped up again in a very quick fashion?
Timing. Hitting is timing. I think guys just got to get their timing back. Pitchers are going to be coming in, throwing pretty good. I'm sure I know our guys have been throwing bullpens and playing catch. But just trying to get that timing back and get back going again. And hopefully 2 or 3 weeks into it, we'll be ready to go.
Have you already had discussions as an organization as far as how you are going to bring guys along, knowing that this second spring training, if and when it happens, will likely be much shorter than the first one?
We haven't talked too much about it because we just don't know what's really happening. But if we get somewhere close, I'm sure we'll start talking as a staff to make sure we're getting our guys prepared and ready to go.
Marcus, you talked about the not knowing. What is the anticipation like right now, knowing that everybody is just missing baseball?
You know, everybody, like, you know, our coaching staff, we have a conference call with each other, and everybody's ready to go. We just don't know what's going to happen, but we're just hoping that both sides can get together and we can get back out there. Just make sure everybody's safe first. That's the main thing. But we're all chomping at the bit to get going again because we miss it. That's all we've done for a long time. So, and I think everybody in the country and in New York and Tampa and all over the place need some baseball.
And Marcus, I can tell you, everyone at the Yes Network is missing it as well. So thank you so much for joining us. Please stay safe. And hopefully I see you at Steinbrenner Field soon.
Me too. Take care. Thank you.